Hey everyone, it's me Suchita. Welcome back to the channel. I hope you all are doing absolutely fine. Today in this video I'm going to talk about the interview calls. If you are someone who are keep on applying for the jobs but you are not getting the interview calls, what can be the reason and how you can improve, how you can end up getting a call? Do watch the video till the end and I'm sure by following these tips you're definitely going to get a calls in the coming few days. So without delaying, let's start today's video. If you are new to the channel, do consider subscribing and press the bell icon because I'm making all the content related to job market, parenting tips and certain lifestyle skills. I'm just trying to add some values in your life. So without delaying, let's start today's video. First one is update your profile completely, or you can say 100% on Naukri.com. See, all of us, especially in India, when we are looking for a job, we all of us will register ourselves on Naukri.com. But what is the exactly mistake we will do? There are many things that website is asking for and then we will fill certain options. You can just see a bar under the Naukri.com. You will see how much percent it is complete. It should be 100% complete. I know it will take time, but please do that, because if the profile is 100% complete, then only the website is going to give your profile as a reference to the recruiters. If the profile is not complete till 100%, then there are less chances that the profile will reach to the people. So try to complete the profile as much and till 100% if possible. Second one is keep on updating your profile. Yes, whatever search engine you are using, maybe you are using Naukri.com, LinkedIn or anyone, what you need to do, you need to keep on updating your profile in that. Even though you don't have any updates, still you just make some changes, delete something and then add the same thing so that it will show that you have updated your profile on that particular date and time. What happened? These search engines are working with certain algorithms. And they will just keep the profile and in the form of rank, and your profile will automatically go up in the ranking when you will update it. And if one profile which is not updated from a very long time, it will automatically go down. So that's how it's very important to keep on updating your profile. And even though if you are sending mails to the recruiter, still you need to send your mail, you need to keep on sending a reminder. See, the recruiters are getting the thousands of mails every week. So maybe they don't have any requirement this 15 days, and maybe after 15 days they do have a requirement. So they will just go down in their email and they will check what are the last 10 or 15 mails they have received. So for example, you are targeting certain institution and you want to have a job in that particular company or institution. What you need to do, you need to keep on sending a reminder mail to that particular institute after a certain period, maybe by a gap of 15 days or a month. You just repeat your profile and send it again to the mail ID of the recruiter. Next one is the resume headline. Even you are submitting your CV or resume, your headline should be very catchy. You are uploading your profile on a recruiter website, the search engine, or maybe you are sending through a mail. Whatever will be the headline of your subject of your resume, work really well. When the person is going to download your CV, it must be showing your name, experience and certain skills, which you can say, for example, Suchita, chemistry teacher plus 10 years of teaching experience. So it's showing I'm a chemistry teacher specialized in chemistry plus I do have an experience of 10 years in teaching. So in that way you need to make it catchy and summarize yourself. By looking at the headline, the person can understand whatever all he is looking for, that is the qualification or that is the package is available in that particular resume. So that will make the recruiter attractive, or you can say make the recruiter download your CV.
Next one is the verified contact details. For example, you are going to mention the phone number. Do try to mention 2 to 3 contact details. If that particular frame of time and the recruiter is trying to call you, so if one number is not available, then the other should be available at that time. So try to add 2 to 3 numbers in your resume. Plus, just arrange them according to the priority, one which is mostly available, and you will be available in that number very easily. So do mention that, and just following that. So just mention, arrange the phone number, plus do share the email ID. Some people just mention the mobile number and they forget to mention the email ID. For example, if the person is not trying to call you, they can just send you a professional mail and they just ask for the other details, whatever they are looking for. So do mention the email ID, which will increase your chances to contact by the recruiter. Next one is to set up as a brand. See, you need to sell your skills as a brand. You need to set your brand value in the market. How? Whenever you are designing a CV, make it crisp and short. Plus, do try to mention your job responsibility. Elaborate them in a way so that it will show your maximum strength. For example, when I was working in my last school, I was working as a head of the department. I was working as an exam coordinator. I was the in charge of the games activity. In that way, you are showing that you are a complete package for that particular job. In that way, you are showing your skills, that with one job profile, they are getting something in addition. Maybe you are good in robotics and you can handle the robotics activity side by side. So do try to highlight those skills apart from your particular or main job, what all you can do for the school. Maybe you will add a certain value which exactly you are looking for. For example, you are a math teacher and you are good in abacus. Many schools are really looking and they are very short of the abacus skill teacher, because this is a new skill and every school try to implement as an extra activity, but they are not willing to hire a teacher who is good in abacus, and they are not ready to pay as a regular. So as a math teacher, you can handle their abacus activity as well. So that's how you need to show your strength and you need to show your brand value in your CV. Now, last is a bonus tip. It's not a bonus tip, it's exactly my heart. It's a learning from my personal experience. Do not leave hope. Keep trying. I know I was a person who's not at all outstanding in something, but got hired and now earning very well with a good salary package. So do not leave hope at all. Keep on trying, and every day just get up with a positive hope and do try. Send thousands of mails by leaving a zero hope. See, when you are going to send 1,000 mail, maybe that one reply will come from that. So by just sending 10 mails, you are expecting one reply. Do not keep, because nowadays the global recession is there because of this pandemic situation. Every country, every job profile is facing one and another down phase. So please have patience, do not leave hope, and keep on trying. I believe me, if you will follow all these tips and you will not leave hope, definitely you will end up a job offer soon. So on that note, do mention if you will add to have any thing from your experience, and I will shout out your name by adding that comment in my video. That's all for today. Have a nice day. Keep growing in your career, keep learning, keep sharing. Thank you. Bye-bye.